our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins. Your Son, to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You claim to all sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Thessalonians. As to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our being gathered together to him, we beg you, brothers and sisters, not to be quickly shaken in mind or alarmed, either by spirit or by word or by letter, as though from us, to the effect that the day of the Lord is already here. Let no one deceive you in any way. For this purpose he called you through our proclamation of the good news, so that you may obtain the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. So then, brothers and sisters, stand firm and hold fast to the traditions that you were taught by us, either by word of mouth or by our letter. Now may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who loved us and through grace gave us eternal comfort and good hope, comfort your hearts and strengthen them in every good work and word. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Say among the nations, the Lord is king. The world is firmly established, it shall never be moved. He will judge the peoples with equity.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar and all that fills it. Let the field exult and everything in it.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Then shall all the trees of the forest sing for joy before the Lord, for he is coming. For he is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Alleluia, alleluia. The word of God is living and active. It probes the thoughts and motives of our hearts.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Father,
Pharisees, hypocrites, for you tithe mint, dill, cumin, and have neglected the weightier matters of the law, justice, and mercy, and faith. It is these you ought to have practiced, without neglecting the others. You blind guides, you strain out a gnat, but swallow a camel. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you clean the outside of the cup and of the plate, but inside they are full of greed and self-indulgence. You blind Pharisee, first clean the inside of the cup, so that the outside may also become clean. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
One of the privileges of being a deacon is that at the end of Mass, I get to purify the chalice, as you'll see after communion time. And since we believe that even in the smallest particle of the Eucharist, Jesus is fully present, we take great care to make sure that the entire chalice is perfectly clean and purified. And it makes me think when I do it sometimes that, you know, what if I took this amount of care in other parts of my life as well? What if I was also very careful about being pure and taking care of just the smallest details of my own life? And today's gospel made me think of that when Jesus says, first clean the inside of the cup so that the outside may also become clean. In our culture today, we see people take incredible care to actually make sure that they do everything that they can to prevent COVID from spreading. And so hand sanitizers, masks, all these things, we take great care. And there's really good reason for that. But it also should call us to think about how much care we actually take for other things, like avoiding sin. You know, what if we took as much care as we do for COVID for sin? What if with family members we made sure that, you know, we didn't go to a place that might spread, you know, COVID? Well, how about like ensuring family members, like, don't go to that website, don't go to that place, don't hang out with those friends? You know, COVID is very good for us to be very careful and ensure that COVID is not spread, but we can be inspired by the care we take in this time of COVID to also realize that the spiritual is actually far more important. You know, the saint of today, King Louis, he wrote this great letter to his son, and he told his son, I'd rather see you catch leprosy than commit a mortal sin. And leprosy at the time was the worst thing you could possibly get. So it's like the king today saying, you know, I'd rather see you catch COVID than commit a mortal sin. And so today, we can be inspired by COVID to take our faith more seriously. Just as I try to be inspired every day by purifying the chalice, to take every little detail of my life more seriously.
We've all gathered here, dear brothers and sisters, to celebrate the mystery of our redemption. Let us therefore ask Almighty God that the whole world may be watered from the springs of all blessing and life.
Through the intercession of St. Louis, King of France, we pray for the conversion of Donald Trump, for Prime Minister Trudeau, for all those who hold public office. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Pope Francis, Bishop Joseph, Archbishop Michael, for all leaders in the church, that they may be faithful shepherds for the people of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Renewal of this parish community and for the conversion of many souls in Whistler. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are on the front lines of battling COVID, for an end to this disease, and that new conversions may happen through these challenging times. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Mass is being offered up in a special way for the holy souls in purgatory. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the moment of silence, we offer up our own prayers and petitions. Praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the holy souls in purgatory. We ask that you join us with the saints and angels in heaven, especially Saint Joseph, our Blessed Mother, Saint Louis. We pray for more vocations to the priesthood, to the consecrated life of the Holy Matrimony, to preserve all the roles in their vocations, and assist us in our universal call of holiness. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May your mercy, we beseech you, O Lord, be with your people who cry to you, so that what they seek at your prompting may be obtained by your ready generosity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer. Through to the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of
heaven. Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer. Through to the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Sacrifice offered once for all. bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for although you have no need of our prayers, yet our thanksgiving is itself in vain. Since our praise has nothing to your greatness, but profits us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Be holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, I come to you spiritually into my heart, and I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit you to be separated.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.